hopeful and idealized side of existence. The ex-colored man's tale throws into suspicion this hopeful and idealized side of existence in the North by explaining the complicated power connection still based on vain there. To be confirmed, the teller becomes a successful and respected member of community in New York and shifts up the social scale, which is one of the models often expressed in thrill tales, even to the extent of some ex-slaves mobilizing in the ranks of the English aristocracy. However, in a highly ironic motion, the teller is shown to accomplish such situation only by being an ex-colored man, by making himself a thrall to whiteness. Adaptability may surely be a design for saving some physical advantage from an intolerable condition of ethnic denigration, a method of earning from infallible accomplishment, a way within the restricted options obtainable of beating the constraining cultivation at its own way and of proving one's mankind in the procedure. But here James also lets us glance the terror of the black settled subject, who is obviously compared to the free African American, like the complete imitative individual who has become so skilled at the art of simulation that his blackness has been a blackness, a non-attendance or void biting to be loaded by the personality of the colonizing cultivation. So hope is the erasure of an African patrimony. So India is the cultural assimilation into Euro-American values. That physical bondage is avoided. The obedient subject possesses himself. What starts as achievement becomes an identity. Actually, prosperous crossing forward by black American people to the expansion that they drive their lifetimes completely within Euro-American cultivation, as the dealer does, may frame the diminutive act of ethnic and cultural imitation, the destruction of a residual African egoism. While the function playing may have devastating possibility, it also has the capability to contain and alter the door. James deliberately recalls the connotation of genre in the giving a title for his tale. Anyway, in order to reply to it in the record of spoof, he is obviously involved in this type of playful and fruitful violation of the frontiers between nonfiction and fiction when he passes his tale off as autobiography.